In our previous video, we talked about categorizing heart sounds into four groups. Today, we're focusing on the first category, normal heart sounds. Before we begin, if you haven't watched the introductory video, we recommend checking it out for context. Now, let's dive in. The normal heart sounds comprise first and second heart sounds, known as S1 and S2 respectively. S1 emerges with the closure of the mitral and tricuspid valves, signifying the end of ventricular diastole and the beginning of systole. Conversely, S2 arises as the aortic and pulmonary valves close, marking the end of ventricular systole. Let's explore each sound one by one, starting with S1. S1, generated by the closure of the mitral and tricuspid valves, is best heard at the cardiac apex. Some diseases can amplify S1, while others may cause it to diminish. S1 is loud in cases of mitral stenosis. That's because the narrowed mitral valve hinders complete emptying of the left atrium during ventricular diastole. The larger residual volume of blood elevates left atrial pressure. And thus, as a result, loud S1 due to heightened closure of the mitral valve against the elevated left atrial pressure. It's important to recognize that S1 remains loud only as long as the mitral leaflets retain their pliability. However, when the valves become calcified, S1 softens. Soft S1 is also detected in cases of mitral regurgitation and conditions characterized by prolonged diastolic filling time, such as left bundle branch block. Please note that alterations in S1 due to tricuspid stenosis and tricuspid regurgitation are similar to mitral stenosis and mitral regurgitation. Now, let's discuss S2. As previously mentioned, S2 occurs when the aortic and pulmonary valves close. It's typically best heard in the aortic and left parasternal areas. In some individuals, it's normal to hear a split in S2, allowing you to distinguish the closure of the aortic and pulmonary valves separately. Under normal conditions, the aortic valve closes before the pulmonary valve, resulting in the split S2 being denoted as A2P2. This phenomenon is termed physiological splitting, and its duration varies across different respiratory phases. During inspiration, the split widens, while it decreases or may disappear entirely during expiration. What causes this variation? Let's delve into cardiac physiology. During inspiration, there's heightened venous return to the right side of the heart. Consequently, the emptying of the right ventricle and the closure of the pulmonary valve are delayed. This leads to an augmented splitting of S2. Conversely, during expiration, the splitting diminishes or may even vanish altogether. Now that we've covered the physiology of S2 and its normal splitting, let's delve into its abnormalities. Abnormalities in S2 can affect its intensity and splitting. First, let's discuss intensity. S2 can either become louder or softer in certain conditions. The A2 component becomes louder in systemic hypertension and congenital aortic stenosis, while the P2 component may become louder in pulmonary hypertension. Conversely, A2 softens in calcific aortic stenosis and aortic regurgitation. softening of P2 is clinically not significant. After discussing S2 intensity, let's now explore abnormalities in S2 splitting. S2 splitting can fall into one of three subcategories: wide physiological splitting, fixed splitting, and reverse splitting. We've previously discussed how physiological splitting widens during inspiration. Additionally, conditions that delay the emptying of the right ventricle or prompt premature closure of the aortic valve can augment S2 splitting. Consequently, physiological splitting widening is observed in conditions such as right bundle branch block, pulmonary stenosis, ventricular septal defect, and mitral regurgitation. Notably, the first three conditions delay right ventricular emptying, whereas mitral regurgitation leads to the early closure of the aortic valve. The next type of S2 splitting is called fixed splitting. Fixed splitting occurs when S2 remains unchanged throughout the respiratory cycle, unaffected by inhalation or exhalation. This occurs due to an abnormal connection between the right and left atria, maintaining consistent right-sided blood volume during both breathing phases. You may have guessed correctly from pathophysiology that fixed splitting occurs in an atrial septal defect. Moving on to the final type of S2 splitting, known as reverse splitting. In simple terms, reverse splitting is the opposite of normal S2 splitting. Here, the split widens during exhalation and narrows or disappears during inhalation. Unlike wide physiological splitting, reverse splitting indicates either delayed left-sided cardiac emptying or rapid emptying of the right side of the heart. Reverse splitting is observed in left bundle branch block, aortic stenosis, coarctation of the aorta, and patent ductus arteriosus. That concludes our discussion on normal heart sounds. In the next video, we have discussed the next category, extra heart sounds. Thanks for watching. We hope you found the video content valuable. If you find our video content valuable, give us a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this. See you in the next one.